What's going on, people? Kevin Hart here in Jackson, Mississippi. I don't know if you noticed or not, but this is the home of the blues. Blues were originated here, huh? It's broken. It ain't doing what it's supposed to do. I'm on my farm right now. I bought it, 68 acres. Got it for a cool $32. Chickens, goats, geese, ducks. What else I got down here? Wild orangutan. Everything is on here. It's all mine. I own it. Not only our farm is beautiful here, but so is comedy. Oh my God, it's nothing better than some good old down-home comedy in Jackson, Mississippi. And we're gonna see it today. Why? Well, because this is Heart of the City season 2. And I'm gonna give you guys the best. We're headed down to Club Next Level. I think I'm gonna drive my tractor down there. Let's go. I said, let's go. Right now. Here we go. Okay. I'ma walk. I'll be there for 6 hours.
The comedy game is a grind. It's gritty. To get to the top, you gotta go through the underground. I'm talking bars, small rooms, strip clubs. Travel with me and my boys as we spotlight the hottest new comedians in the country. My name is Kevin Hart, and welcome to Heart of the City.
I'm in Jackson, Mississippi, with some amazing talent. I got Marvin Hunter, Merc B, Rita Brent, and Ben Compton. If you guys could describe comedy in Jackson, Mississippi in one word, what would you describe it as?
I would say growing.
Growing.
Typically, when you think about Mississippi, you think about fried chicken and Morgan Freeman. You don't think about comedy. But now, you're thinking about comedy.
I love an intimate comedy room. I don't think there's a better setting that's so close-knit. You feel like you know them.
Yeah.
How long you been doing comedy?
About 3 years now.
3 years.
Rita actually brought me to Jackson originally. Okay. She seen me on YouTube, brought me to a show she was putting on.
Why'd you grab him? What happened?
Be honest, I needed some diversity on the show, and he's white, so that's why I had to give him 40. Yeah,
I love that. Yeah. Hey. Flat out honesty.
Yeah.
To be honest, I needed a white boy.
And he's funny.
What about you? How long have you been coming?
2 years now. It all happened by mistake.
What?
I have an identical twin brother.
Okay.
He moved to Memphis, but he still had gigs. And so I was like, hey, let me host your gigs for you.
Y'all did a twin switch.
Yeah, literally, this happened like that. They thought I was him. And he lives in Atlanta now, so I'm pretty sure he's on the streets right now. So y'all gonna see me on Hard to See. Y'all gonna see me. You know, I'm pretty sure he's gonna say that.
What's your style of comedy, Marvin?
Grumpy Uncle.
The Grumpy Uncle?
Yeah, Grumpy Uncle.
Is that what you are in real life?
Yeah. I got divorced, health took everything. So,
okay. Wait a second.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That's what pissed you off.
Oh, yeah.
Angry
yeah.
about everything.
About everything.
About everything. We are performing at the Next Level Experience. Is there a little bit of fear in your performance tonight?
Hell yeah. I feel like in doing comedy, you always have a fear at each show.
Just like being in the military, being in the war zone, when you step on that stage, man, in front of people, same fear. Skin crawls, but you gotta do what you gotta do.
I don't know if I can compare the war to the stage.
It's the same feeling. Yeah. It's the same anxiety.
You're gonna see a different level of Kevin Hart if a bullet fly past my head, brother. I don't know if I'm gonna get to the punchline. I gotta stay in it.
Yeah, man, that step over there ain't fat people friendly, man. Not at all, man. Doctor told me yesterday I gotta lose some weight. Told me I gotta start eating healthy or else. He ain't tell me it's gonna be this damn expensive to eat healthy. Got this place by my house called Whole Foods. They should call it Whole Ass. Because that's what you're gonna spend. Two booty cheeks and an anus. Just gonna set that on the counter when you go in there. Lady tried to send me some $9 bologna. I was like, I gone had this little light stroke. I'm not gonna spend no $9 on no bologna. What the hell kind of animal make $9 bologna? What is this, dolphin forehead meat? This unicorn lips? Are y'all here selling mythical beast meat? The chicken high? I'm like, why the chicken hot? She say, because the chicken free range. I'm like, what is free range? So, you know, we let the chicken walk around. We don't, you know, we let them walk around and live their life, you know. I'm like, well, it sounds like y'all promoting up in the chickens. That's what it sounds like to me. I like my chicken with low self-esteem, you know what I'm saying? Popeye's chicken tastes way up ahead, you know what I'm saying? They remove stuff from the food, jack the price up. And there's always something we can't verify. Who here ever seen a gluten? You ever laid out on a gluten? Give me all my damn gluten. Give me a double shot of gluten. Matter of fact, pour my gluten on my food like it's gravy. Hey, ma'am. I done got married again. Y'all pray for me. Yeah. I'm glad I'm with somebody, though. I can't be out here dating. I don't know how y'all do it, man. Especially a little young girl. Young girls had that look on their face like they want to screw on work nights. I'm not for screwing on work night. My sleep important to me. I'm not screwing on work night. All the little soft breathing on your neck trying to wake you up. That guy, I'm horny. Better lay your ass down. Lay your ass down, little rambunctious ass. Lay down! I took the CPAP machine off and everything. You know how hard it is to go to sleep with a CPAP machine? You know, when you get a certain age, you want to do it when you want to do it. Young girl won't wear her little program go off all these reality shows, you know. I don't like the reality show. Them reality shows, all they do is empower side hoes. And they already unruly. Remember when side hoes had honor? Remember when side hoes were respectable human beings? You used to tell a side hoe, look, don't call my phone past 8. And she wouldn't call your phone past 8. Try it now. Be 11 o'clock at night. Brrr. Hello, hey, what you doing? I'm trying to read the Bible to my children. Now, we talking about this now. This is why I ain't want to do this. I think I'm with my soulmate, I don't know. Yeah, I think I'm with my soulmate now. Yeah. She do all the little sexy things I like. You know, we all got little sexy stuff we like. She work or she cook. Boy, that make me firm off in the zipper. You know what I'm talking about? Ooh, that arouse me. I like it when they work and they cook. People stay in old marriages year after year after year. And like they don't know what the signs is to get out the marriage. The signs are clearly there. We ignore the signs. I'm gonna tell you one of the signs right now to let you know it's time to get out of your marriage. When you start thinking about stuff that don't go together. Like you wake up in the middle of the night and you thirsty. But your next thought is, I'll punch this bitch in her face. It's time. Go on, get your paperwork together. Cause somebody gonna get hurt. Why would you punch her in her face? That ain't gonna quench your thirst. Ex-wife, I always wanna fuss. I don't like a bunch of fussing in my house. I always wanna compare our relationship to a girlfriend relationship. I gotta hear that, you know. Shirley say, you need to be praising me cause I slave over stove cooking hot meals for you and your son. But see, her and Shirley be exaggerating. Spaghettis and wieners is not a meal. What the hell, you think we a summer camp? Cooking spaghettis and wieners every other day. Even my son get frustrated. He's 4 years old. He come downstairs looking at the kitchen and be like, aw. Spaghettis again? Yes, son. Spaghettis again. Your mammy gonna kill us with these spaghettis. Hey, that's my time. I'm Marvin Hunter. Appreciate y'all. Thank y'all so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Coming up.
Ooh, that is.
Granted, this ain't the damn time for me to take a lesson.
Joey, look at this.
This can't be real.
Welcome to Kevin Hart Farms.
You got a farm.
Ooh, that is.
Oh, ah, Jesus.
There you go.
What is he doing right now?
Welcome to my farm.
What do you know about farming?
Not a damn thing, Harry. That's why I got you two here. I know you from Gaffney, South Carolina.
That's right.
So I need you to milk them goats. You got to get them goats milked and milk fast. Joey, I'm out here growing my own stuff. Mm-hmm. I went organic.
I ain't mad at you. What's this?
That right there?
Yeah.
Could be a penis or a vegetable. I don't know. That thing came out the ground fast. Yeah, don't eat that.
Well, where your protein at? You got to have protein.
I don't have no protein yet.
We got you.
What's that?
Your neighbor. He was selling some meat.
You talking about Carl?
Yep.
We bought a cow patty from him.
Sold us some cow patties.
Carl gave y'all some cow patties.
Yeah, yeah, we're gonna fry them up. We need a little bit of your tomatoes, a little bit of lettuce, gonna put it.
Don't eat them cow patties.
Well, it's more for us if you ain't gonna eat them.
That's not what you think it is.
Grill some onions.
You wanna listen to Noah?
I'm gonna put cheese on mine.
Grill some onions. Do what you want. I'm not gonna argue with you. Do what you want.
It's hamburger meat.
After you do it, don't put your mouth on none of my organic. And you gonna take the word literally, trust me. Carl, you got some nerve for this!
There's some onions on here. This'll be good.
Open that.
Oh, Lord. That ain't meat, bro.
Mm-hmm. That's dookie.
I think they call it manure.
It's dookie.
You carried it for 5 miles.
Hey, if you were born and raised in Mississippi, make some noise. Born and raised. Yeah, that's right. I'm a proud Mississippian. I am. Folks always be asking me, Rita, you ain't scared to live in Mississippi? I said, no, I've been living in Mississippi all my life, and all my life I had to fight. It ain't but one thing I'm scared of, and that's having kids, y'all. Oh, I don't want to have kids. I done had bad experiences. I used to be a substitute teacher. Yeah, that was the worst time of my damn life. I hated them kids. All of them had the devil in them. I swear they did. And the worst part about being a substitute teacher, believe it or not, was calling the roll. Because some of you parents got some crazy names for your kids. I was substitute for a kindergarten class one day, right? I was going down the road. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. I said, Chlamydiana? She said, present. I say, Shazika virus? She said, present. Then I ran across the name Shirley. I said, Shirley? I said, baby, you ain't but 6 years old. Why in the hell is your name Shirley? She said, I don't know. I said, well, I don't know how to treat you. I feel like I need to show you respect. Miss Shirley, get in line, Miss Shirley. Clean your desk off, Miss Shirley. But she thought she was an old woman too, y'all. One day I told the students to bring their favorite snack to school. All the other kids brought Airheads and Skittles. What you think Miss Shirley brought? A sweet potato pie, 6 years old. Sweet potato pie. Talking about she made it from scratch. I said, you ain't know how to trace your damn name on the paper. You ain't made no pie from scratch. And she must have ate too much pie. She came to school the next day. She said, Miss Brent, my blood pressure high. Well, I sent her to the school nurse, right? She came back. I said, Miss Shirley, what the nurse say wrong with you? She said, Miss Brent, the nurse say I got dementia. I said, if you don't sit your little elderly, sit your little elderly ass down talking about you got dementia. Lord, I've been so nervous for this show. I've been had gas all day. I called my grandma. She said, take a laxative, Rita. I said, Granny, this ain't the damn time for me to take a laxative. Hung up the phone. I ain't lying. I be having gas. You know, my stomach be toe up. See, white people, y'all don't know what toe up is. Y'all stomach be upset. Ours is toe up. You know, when you got gas, you better let it out. I let mine out anywhere. I don't care where the hell I am. Sir, you ever farted and watched somebody walk into your fart? You ever done that? I know. I did it the other day. I was in the mall in the shoe section at the JCPenney. I grabbed down to get a pair of shoes, and all of a sudden, I felt a warm sensation in the crack of my ass. And I said, uh-oh, because you know the warmer it is, the worse it is, right? So I bent down to grab the shoe. I let it ease out, and I just stepped back, right? And I sat there. A few seconds later, a lady walked right into my fart. Old lady. She was an old lady, and I was watching. And it was funny till she started choking. I had to help her. I said, don't you swallow the damn fart. You're going to die. Don't swallow. Ain't nothing worse than having a tore-up stomach when you're at work, ain't it? That's the worst time to have it. See, when you do the number 2 at work, you ain't got time to fool around. You got to get in there and get out before somebody see your shoes. Can I get a witness? Oh, Lord, I ain't lying. Because once they see your shoes, you know it's over with, right? You be in the hallway, think you done got away with murder. Your co-worker see you, be like, hey, look down and be like, I'll be down. That was you in there blowing up the bathroom. Like, that wasn't me. You're like, yes, it was. I remember them shoes. Now, you the funky booty girl at work. You don't want that kind of reputation, y'all. So get like me. I got some regular shoes and some shit shoes. Come on, somebody. Better get you some. Them Skechers, they real good for doo-dooing. Skechers. Hey, that's my time. I'm Rita Brent. Thank you.
Coming up,
white people.
I've never been so offended in my life.
If you don't know how to spell Mississippi, I'll tell you how to spell it. M-I, crooked letter I, humpback I.
M-I, crooked letter.
Yes.
It's, the joke is out spelling it wrong.
I'm gonna get real with you for a minute. I'm going through a rough time in life. I'm getting older. I'm pushing 30. Older I get, the more I realize my body's starting to change. Went clothes shopping the other day, realized I was shaped like a 16-year-old pregnant girl. And I say that because my chest says small, but my gut says large. I wish this milk would come on in so it would even out. Golly. I'm in what's called an interracial marriage. So I'm white. I know that's amazing. My wife is black with three daughters. Not only am I the only male in my house, I'm the only white person in that bitch too. All my kids put together don't even equal a whole white person. I'm not good at math, but like 3/4 ain't no whole. I don't care how you add it up. I don't care. Cool though, man. My oldest daughter, she's the one that always reminds me I'm the only white person in the house. Like, we was watching the news the other day, something happened, and she was like, ugh, white people. I've never been so offended in my life. I said, first of all, them your people on there acting crazy too. I told her, the only thing keeping your ass from being full-time white is your birth certificate. I will change that tomorrow. Like, I'm just that petty. I really am. Me and my oldest daughter were the closest in the home, you know. She's in the fourth grade. That's a hard time for me, because she's starting to realize, like, what boys are. And that scares me, because I'm the size of every fourth grade boy in her class. Like, I never really grew up. I just got older, you know what I'm saying? I feel like fourth grade is kind of where I peaked at, you know? Hey, my name's Ben Compton. That's my time, man. Y'all have been great.
All right, yeah, it's a time limit on these pants, so let's keep it going. All right. Just in case you don't like anything that you hear up here, I have an identical twin brother, so this is his ass telling these jokes tonight. I'm real bitter about it, though. I'm bitter, man. I'm bitter because when we were little, I got a whooping twice for him. My mom right there. She can tell you. I got a whooping twice for him. So I'm getting a whooping. If you're black in here, you get it. When white folks, you know about timeout. You probably don't know about no whooping. So I get the whooping, man. I always got us in trouble. So I get the whooping, man. My auntie to whoop my ass. I leave out crying, but I f***ing come back in the room. My cousin takes my brother and hides him under the bed. I come back in the room. My auntie don't know us apart. She start whooping my ass again. I'm like, I'm not him. So I got a chance to get him back to that. So a few years ago, I got pulled over. And so, I ain't had no license, no registration, none of that stuff. But you know, he had his license and his registration. So we twins, so it's like we had our license and registration. And so, I spouted out his social and everything, man. It was so funny to the officer was like, that's a felony. I was like, oh, no. I know these jeans is gay, but I'm not. Not at all. Not built for jail. I'm Merc B, man.
Thank you. This show is simply built to create a platform, create a launching pad for this up-and-coming generation. And I think sometimes places like Jackson, Mississippi are overlooked. So I love the fact that we came here and we got to see how you guys get down in Jackson, Mississippi. Y'all make some noise for these amazing comedians. Come back up here again.
Rita, Merc, Ben, Marvin. Thank you guys so much.
Take a bow, guys. Take a bow.
Dr. Cindy Ayers.
Thank you so much. I'm a native Mississippian. Mm-hmm. And part of Footprint for a Mission is to help fight diabetes and hypertension right here in Mississippi with all the obesity, to bring healthier foods into the schools, and also to create entrepreneurs.
This initiative is amazing. A yellow heart belt for Heart of the City.
It is. It's exactly for you.
Yeah. Join me in simply smiling at what Cindy is doing.